because we expect it to be up to 15 exahash by August, September. All of a sudden, now we're at 10, and we should be at 18 by then, the way the numbers are growing. So I think that the acquisition of those other assets really fast-tracked our growth.
Welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. Joining me now is Frank Holmes, Executive Chairman of HIVE Digital Technologies. And Frank, it's always great to have you on. How are you?
I'm great, my friend. I just came back from a week in Las Vegas. 35,000 people attended. Vice President J.D. Vance spoke, in addition to Michael Saylor, which packed the room. Other companies like Meta Planet, which is the best performing stock in the world, that adopted that model of owning Bitcoin as a treasury. So it was very exciting.
Yeah, you got to bring a big message there, and that is that the company has hit 10 exahash, which is a very key milestone for a number of different reasons. Frank, talk us through why this is so key.
Well, in the gold space, you find a junior gold stock that's producing 60, 70,000 ounces a year, really can't get much traction with institutions. And when it goes through 100,000 ounces of gold producer, it's still a junior, but it starts getting a higher valuation for the same revenue and the same cash flow when they do multiples. And then the next big threshold is 500,000 ounces, and then it's 1 million ounces. And very few mining companies get to that threshold of 1 million ounce gold producer. So what you see seeing in the Bitcoin ecosystem is hitting 10 exahash, then hitting 20 exahash. So we are now through the 10 exahash, and that all of a sudden creates a greater quality for institutions for investment grade.
Yeah, Frank, how are you able to do it so quickly? I mean, it seems almost every week you're increasing your exahash to the point where you're now at 10.
Well, we explained that the acquisition of Bitfarms facilities in Paraguay, they were only partially done, and we could fast track the finishing of them. And that really accelerated our program because we expected to be up to 15 exahash by August, September. All of a sudden, now we're at 10, and we should be at 18 by then, the way the numbers are growing. So I think that the acquisition of those other assets really fast tracked our growth. And also, Steve, that we had a surplus of miners, which were really not profitable in Canada, but they're profitable because the cost of energy is cheaper. And one penny does make it significant. So we were able to plug in immediately a surplus of machines. And that's the other, key factor.
Yeah, Frank, you're obviously surrounded by some HPC, some high computing computers there, and your budget HPC, which is a subsidiary of the company, has now hit a $20 million run rate. It's really impressive.
Yeah, it's very exciting for us, and hiring a new president to run that operation, Greg Tavares, who has a wonderful track record in Canada, has been, taking it to the next level and allowing Aydin Kilic to really focus on this sort of massive growth that we're doing in Paraguay. And so Craig is doing a great job. We think that we'll get to the 50 million, hopefully by year end, as we look at operations and where those opportunities are. So we're very thrilled. Our H200s are up going, the NVIDIA chips. So very, very exciting for the company.
And just on that, Frank, how important is it to have a subsidiary like that doing so well in order to support what you're doing on the Hive side as well? It sounds like they're really working in conjunction to move forward and really fuel growth.
Well, both are data centers, so therefore they both need electricity and they both need this infrastructure. The only part with high performance computing, the cost of the infrastructure is 10 times or more what it costs for a Bitcoin facility. So what you're seeing around the world is the building for the Bitcoin facilities capturing stranded electricity and surplus ex electricity is the setting stage for high performance computing. And we've seen this in the US where hyperscalers like CoreWeave have gone and partnered with Core Scientific because they had Bitcoin mining surplus electricity. And all they have to do is spend more money on their data centers to get up to be able to use the AI of the big boom is the AI. But I think that that's what it is. And so we're very excited about this. What you also have to realize is that when you go down the high performance computing, you also have to have the fiber optics. So the telecom companies have to have spent the fiber optics. So we have found that really some of the properties we have are stranded, not because of our electricity now, because the telecom companies haven't kept up the speed with the huge explosion in the capacity of the NVIDIA chips. But they're all, everyone's running. And I think the big operative word, Steve, you're going to hear more and more this year is called sovereign data centers. That is, Quebec doesn't want their data center, like governments in another province. US doesn't want it in another country. Texas doesn't want it in Louisiana. The idea of protecting the data and the value of your data is growing dramatically with the ability to analyze the data with AI chips.
Exciting times ahead for sure, Frank. Thanks so much. Great to see you again.
It's great to be with you.
All right, Frank Holmes, the executive chairman of HIVE Digital Technologies.